The feared G-91YS is the Italian Magid of Cold War fighter planes, and since we covered the basics of turbojet combat in a previous guide, this video's side dish will focus on slightly more advanced topics such as using air-to-air missile armament and high-speed close-air support. Of course, we start with the Motorari Apzones, which happen to be a pair of General Electric J85 GE13A turbojet engines with a total output of just about 2500 kilogram force of thrust, which gives this slightly smaller than a Sabre jet Italian boy a top speed of almost 1123 kilometers per hour on the deck, which is right on the cusp of going supersonic, but that will be a topic for another time. Moving on to flight performance, the YS is generally a great all-round fighter with responsive controls and decent acceleration and great high G maneuvering tolerance, but do mind that your landing gear is allergic to high speeds on takeoff and it's absolutely possible to critically damage your tail and engines if you pull up too quickly. On the other hand, it is also a very easy aircraft to land since it has automatic napkin farts to slow the aircraft down to a complete stop. As mentioned earlier, this aircraft was not designed to break the sound barrier, but this does not mean anything, since even in this modern age of aerial warfare, most new jet pilots will still behave like stupid pigeons with fidget spinners. This means that you, the Chad Machiavelli, will heed the lessons from our previous discussion about the grandfather of jet fighters, and avoid extremely tight horizontal maneuvers at all costs, and instead focus on using combat maneuvers that utilize the oblique and vertical planes in which you will keep and expend your energy at will, as the YS has one of the best power-to-weight ratios for a fighter of its tier. And as long as you are vigilant and continually checking your surroundings, you will be capable of dodging supersonic bias with the grace of a gripper, but not doing so will lead to getting memed on by everything else that is subsonic like an ashamed Caesar with many daggers in his back. Moving on to armament. This fighter is equipped with a pair of the definitely not a potato launcher and French designed Derek Chandez 2D fabrication arm ammo 30mm cannons, which can deliver pain and suffering with just a 1 second burst of hardened pasta per retard who challenges your authority. However, most of you know what happens when you have high velocity autocannons of any kind. Therefore, we will now talk about an alternative offensive armament option available to the YS, which in this case, is a pair of American-made AIM-9B short-range infrared guided air-to-air missiles known as Sidewinders.
At the sound of the explosion, it will be torque o'clock! Toodles! You are welcome!
To any uncultured peasant or military planner of the 1960s, it would seem that having such armament would make having a pair of cannons on an aircraft useless as the missile does all the work for you, and it will work flawlessly every single time on any opponent you can find within visual range.
No!
Of course, this assessment is complete and utter as the 9B is incapable of following tightly maneuvering aircraft, and it has a narrow-minded need to swiggity-swiggy and go after the hottest booty it can find, even if that booty happens to be the sun. This means that you should use the missiles to take out enemy pilots that are either unable to, or too stupid to maneuver out of the way of your flying fuckstick, even with a big bloody warning flashing on their screen. Otherwise they serve only to force aircraft that are faster than you into favorable situations that allow you to gesture your high explosive 30mm meatballs right up their asses.
Gotcha, bitch!
That was brutal! Where's the ref?
Having covered the heat-seeking ass-focused annihilation devices, we can move on to close-air support in top-tier combined forces battles, of which is not only more difficult, since your closing speed onto target is faster than in any prop aircraft, but the threat of radar-guided self-propelled anti-air guns and SAM missiles make traditional high-angle-of-approach ground attack tactics a death wish to anyone stupid enough to try it. Instead, you must dive and fly at extremely low altitudes where these radar-guided anti-air vehicles cannot effectively track and aim their weapons at your incoming delivery of stones or firecrackers of mass destruction. But of course, be aware that being saddled down with more payload guns and prop bombers of years past means that you must take great care to make sure that you do avoid unexpectedly greeting the ground, buildings, or severely elevated terrain features on your way to and from the combat zone. And of course, do not forget to set that godforsaken fuse delay, as even going fast doesn't make you immune from experiencing devastating severe emotional events of all kinds.
Here we go!
It's now time to sit down for a dinner conversation with the usual sides of module and crew skills. As usual, it's best to focus on grabbing the performance and survivability mods, while trying to grab the cannon upgrades as fast as possible, which by then you can go forth and get all the shiny explodey stuff to expend upon all thine enemies. For the crew skills, it's the big three of stamina, vitality, and g-force tolerance, as every little bit of mama's home cooking and glass of wine makes casually pulling 12 g's and surviving multiple head-on attacks just that little bit easier. And that's how you fly the G91YS. Now, get out there, and show the world what it truly means, to be the bringer of death and the deliverer of the spiciest of saucy meatballs and heat-seeking breadsticks.
Goddamn right! Explosion! On behalf of the Tor Corporation, I'd like to say, booyah!